Here, we are going to look at one special type of governors called as inertia governors. And as you know, governors are used for controlling speed of an engine to keep it steady. And inertia governor does it in a very special way. You already know about centrifugal governors, which control the speed of an engine by cutting the fuel or supplying extra fuel whenever the speed changes through a finite value. But it takes time for that finite change to happen. And therefore, the response of a centrifugal governor is always slower. Let me illustrate this point using this graph of angular velocity of an engine against time. And we are going to take the function value at these two points, which is more or less the same. So the engine is running at the same speed at these two instances. And the effect of that speed, the centrifugal force it causes, is also identical. And therefore, the centrifugal governor will not know the difference between these two situations. But look at the slope at these two points. And you'll realize here the rate of change of angular speed, which is alpha, is negative. The speed is reducing, while here the slope is positive. And therefore, what we can do here is going to be different. So here at the negative slope, we can do different things. At a positive slope, we are going to respond with a different action. And that is what an inertia governor does. It senses the rate of change of angular velocity or the angular acceleration and responds to that. Let us now see the construction of an inertia governor and how this rate of change of angular velocity or the angular acceleration can be factored into its response. For that, we are going to start with this flywheel, which is rotating with the angular velocity omega as shown here. And we have a mass mounted on this flywheel, not rigidly connected to it, but mounted through some linkage we'll see later. So this mass is also rotating with the flywheel, and therefore naturally it is going to experience this centrifugal force. Now suppose the flywheel starts speeding up. So there is angular acceleration of the flywheel. Naturally, this mass is also going to experience some tangential acceleration, r into alpha, because of this angular acceleration. And it will also experience an inertia force, which you know is opposite to acceleration, and it will act in this direction. It is pretty much like our car accelerating forward and we experiencing a backward inertia force. So that's what is happening to this mass. Let us now look at the x components of these two forces. So that is the components in this direction. And you will see whenever there is increase in speed, then both these forces will rise and their x components will add up to give a larger resultant. So as far as their x components are concerned, the two forces give the same response to increase in speed. So their x components kind of agree. While if you look at the y components of these two forces, one is pointing upward, one is pointing downward, and therefore they are going to respond conflictingly to any change in speed. And therefore, for designing of a governor which senses the speed, we better use only the x components. So let us fix a spring. And as you know, a spring will respond to a force proportionately. So we can measure the force, sense the force using the spring. And we have mounted it in the x direction so that only where the two forces agree, that part is sensed. So we get a consistent response from these two forces in terms of the spring displacement. Moreover, let's get rid of the y components by placing this mass on a mounting arm like this along the y direction, and we will even pivot it over here. So whatever may be the y components, they will conflict, they will disagree, whatever, they are not going to contribute to any movement of this arm because it is going to pass right through this pivot. And this is our inertia governor. So whenever there is change in speed, it will cause increase in centrifugal force, of course, but we don't have to wait for that. We can directly use this force here, which is the tangential inertia force, to which our inertia governor is going to respond. Of course, you will have some mechanism downstream, which takes this movement of this mounting arm, controls the fuel wall, and thereby the speed of the engine. There is a downside to this too. Because you have mounted this on a flywheel, this eccentric mass is going to cause some unbalance. But of course, that's a different problem.